I want to wish everyone a Shabbat Shalom in these difficult times and pray for those inflicted with this virus, as well as for the rest of us, that we should stay healthy and safe, and especially, of course, to heed all of the recommendations of the medical professionals. This week's parasha, it's a double parasha, Vayakel Pekudei. The parasha Vayakel opens up with a few psukim reminding us of the importance of keeping Shabbat. And then it reverts back into the discussion of the vessels of the Mishkan. And our rabbis learn from this interesting interruption, so to speak, with the few psukim that talk about Shabbat, that even though it's a great mitzvah to build the Mishkan and all of its kelim, the mitzvah of Shabbat overrides the mitzvah even of building the Mishkan. And some of our rabbis interestingly point out that while the Mishkan is extremely holy, it's the holiest place on earth, and it represents the ultimate sanctity of space, the ultimate sanctity of any area, and it actually becomes a dwelling place for the Shekhinah. Nevertheless, Shabbat supersedes the holiness of the Mishkan, because it represents a different type of holiness. It represents a holiness in time. Sanctifying man's time is the ultimate and highest level of sanctity, and which is represented by Shabbat. It's an interesting anecdote that it's very well known that people spend in today's world, they say time is money, which means that time is important because it can bring about the ability to make money. The Gemara in Masechet Holin records that tzaddikim it's the opposite, that for tzaddikim they only value their money because they had to spend their precious time to get it. And so time becomes of the highest level of sanctity. On this Shabbat, as we're coming in, unfortunately, we will be without the sanctity of space. We will be outside of our Bate Knesset, our Mikdash Me'at. Our shuls are considered a mini Mikdash, and we will not be in our synagogues this Shabbat. We will be missing out on so much of what makes a Shabbat usually special and holy. But we have to remember that the true essence of Shabbat transcends all space. The true essence of Shabbat is sanctifying the time. And so therefore, that this Shabbat, let us focus on the beauty of Shabbat that we do have, the sanctity of time. Let us take the time that we have, spend the time with our families. Let's spend that special time discussing Divrei Torah. I think we should all take a little relaxation message and stop talking about the virus over Shabbat when it's not needed. Of course, in an emergency, one must discuss it and have a plan of what to do. In addition, it's also, we have special time. We should really allow our prayers to be meaningful, even though we're praying alone. We should spend the time pouring our hearts to God and praying for our salvation. Some halachot. Of course, we know that pikuach nefesh actually supersedes Shabbat. And therefore, Shabbat may and must be desecrated to save a life. In a situation where it is necessary for a person to get medical care and a person to go and needs to be checked out, of course, he may violate Shabbat. Of course, one needs to be careful that it's medically mandated. Today, as far as I understand, doctors are not encouraging everyone to automatically run to get tested. Only those elderly who are above 70 who need to get themselves tested, or actually it's now 65, who need to get themselves tested should do so. As well as a young person that has very serious symptoms, and one should check with his doctors before violating Shabbat, one should check the situation. Most people, it's not recommended them to go to be checked out in a hospital, as that would be the place where they can actually catch the disease. So therefore, one should be cautious and careful in his approach. Nevertheless, as I mentioned, Shabbat may be desecrated when there is even a safek of pikuach nefesh. Great rabbis also indicated that to avoid a situation where one can become contagious, one might even be allowed to be mehallel Shabbat, if he's healthy, to avoid a situation that brings with it a contagious disease. So therefore, if one had to travel to the hospital for whatever reason, take a relative or himself, and now one finds himself in the hospital in a situation where there is a lot of people that can actually give him the disease and he may be contagious, regardless of how we would normally rule, in this situation it's absolutely and totally permissible to Mehallel Shabbat, to get out of that situation and to return home. I pray for everybody that we have a speedy recovery to this disease. We pray for all those that have been inflicted with this disease. And as I mentioned earlier, we pray that Be'ezrat Hashem, very soon, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will rid us of this illness and send us a speedy cure and ailment for this dreaded disease. Shabbat Shalom.